Two national champions, Junior Bajawa and Omari Kimweri. 10 fights, 9 wins for Bajawa, the Indonesian champion. Kimweri on a 7 fight win streak. And let's take a look at the maths that really matter. Just 1 year separates. They're only little men. 4 centimetres in height, 2 centimetres in reach, both in favour of the Indonesian. Let's go to Howard. It's time to bring the boys out.
Thank you, Andy. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome in the centre ring of 4 rounds of boxing, international super flyweight. Would you welcome in the red corner from the beautiful country of Indonesia, Bali, Junior Bajawa. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome in the blue corner from Deer Park, Melbourne's West via Tanzania, the Lion Man, Omari Kimweri. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Centre Ring. Brian Armatruda, Barry Michael, Sports Simmons Holmes, welcome you to fight number 2. Friday Night Fights. We're going to rock, as Lenny Zabavina just told Andy Raymond. 4 rounds of super flyweight action. In the red corner from Bali, Indonesia, Chief Second Chris Lynn. In professional boxing, 10 fights, 9 wins, only 1 loss, 2 by knockout. Holder, Indonesian, minimum weight title at 51 kilograms even, wearing black trunks predominantly. Would you welcome to Melbourne, Junior Bajawa. And across the ring, wearing similar trunks, white with black trim, from Deer Park, Melbourne's West via the African nation of Tanzania, ex-Aussie flyweight champion Dave Hegarty, Team Destruction. Ladies and gentlemen, professional record of 11 fights, 9 wins, 2 losses, 1 inside the distance. As Andy Raymond said, he's on a roll, 7 consecutive victories at 49.90 kgs. They call him the Lion Man, Omari Kimweri. Referee Chris Anderson Sr., judges Ignatius Misselaitis, Andrew Campbell, and Anika Williams. Here we go, 4 rounds of boxing.
Chris Anderson, once again, the third man in centre ring.
You tell him, remember what we said before, you must remember, yeah?
Yeah.
Remember what we said before, you remember? Okay, good luck, boys. Wait for the bell, yeah? Good luck.
I'm not sure how much was understood at the referee's instructions. Chris Anderson would needed to speak a number of languages to make everything clear.
Round one.
Junior Bajawa, Omari Kimweri, fighting at super flyweight, just over the 50 kilogram limit. Here's Bajawa in the white with the black piping. Ooh. Kimweri in the silver and black.
Nice counter right hook there from Bajawa.
Very similar on paper.
Last fought in June last year. Bajawa, is ring rust going to be an issue? That was a victory for the Indonesian minimum weight title.
Oh, the overhand right from Bajawa.
Caught the attention.
Followed by a head. Yeah, certainly did find the attention of Kimweri. Moved his jaw around a little bit, so obviously felt that. There it is again. That's the third right hand he's landed on Kimweri. As has done Bajawa.
Looks more comfortable playing the countering role here, Bajawa.
Oh,
and again.
Good solid shots from the little guys.
And when we mean little, they are tiny fellows.
There's not many on tall of them, but I've got these guys.
Just. Kimweri.
Oh, good jab.
And it's 8-1, and the glove hit the ground.
Ooh. That certainly landed, and the glove hit the ground.
Yeah.
Interesting. Rules are rules.
Rules are rules, and a couple of debatable points in the opening two matchups. One Benny Horror would be absolutely filthy at.
He's a good, dangerous opponent, Bajawa. His record states 2 fights. 2-0.
But that incomplete through BoxRec, we understand, and then we have documentation from the Indonesian Boxing Council of 10 fights, 9 wins, 2 knockouts. And it's always an issue with a lot of the Asian countries. Either way, it's not ideal, and it presents an awkward position when you've got conflicting stories on records.
That's right, I agree. And the weird thing is that if he has had 2 fights, in his second fight he went 12 rounds. You don't see that too often. I did see Mick Katsidas do it against James Swan up in Toowoomba.
Yeah,
the Australian title when it was back 12 rounds in his second professional fight. Absolute war, went the distance.
Last couple of seconds in this opening round, and perhaps our visitor, Junior Bajawa, could be a little disappointed that a knockdown wasn't ruled midway through the round. Back to the stools we go for the first time here at Superfly.
Listen to me. You've got to double the jab up. What did I say before? You've got to double it up, yeah? Keep a double jab out there, and he won't get you with the right hand. Just poking up a little bit, and just tucking a little bit more with your hand. Got deep breaths, right? Done all right.
We'll have a look at the jab from Bajawa. The counter right hand first. Very dangerous right hand from Bajawa.
He's won 7 in a row.
There we go.
Omari Kimweri, since losing to Anki Ankota.
He certainly wasn't hurt, but the punch landed cleanly, yep, and his glove hit the ground. Find himself pretty unlucky, the Indonesian.
Will that have a bearing on the scorecards if in fact we do go to the judges at the end of 4 rounds?
I think he's still got the round, the Indonesian.
Yep.
Oh, Kimweri lands a left hook.
Red.
Count is on.
5, 6, 7, 8. Are you okay?
Out of nowhere.
Absolutely out of nowhere. And all of a sudden, the former Tanzanian, now based here in Australia, is on top, in control. And a hint of vulnerability about our Indonesian visitor.
The left jab again from Bajawa. Kimweri's got a bit of spring in his step at the moment as he eats a right hand again from Bajawa.
Doesn't matter what sport it is, but confidence and mindset just plays such a huge role, and that is never more evident than Omari Kimweri here. Dropped his opponent, and all of a sudden, a million miles an hour of the feet and the hands are following. Centering, middle stages of round number 2. Only the 2 losses, as I said, one was to Ankota going back 8 fights. But in his second fight, Kimweri was stopped in round 1 by the very durable Ernie Gonzalez. That is going back 4 years now. Nice forward movement, straight punching exhibited by Bajawa.
It's weird to see a fighter who's been a 12-round fighter, as Kimweri has been, come back to a 4-round fight. You think he's moved on into those international honours, and he seems to have come back to 4 rounds. Doesn't make much sense.
Pushing forward.
Nice combination from Kimweri, but well defended by Bajawa. All the heads come together.
It was a big clash. It was a front-on head clash, not a grazing one. And quite often it's those grazing ones that aren't nearly as hard that cause cuts. No juice, no blood, thankfully. Both, obviously, as you look at their styles, very early trained and well trained,
yeah,
in the sport as amateurs with extensive experience. We brought many of those amateur traits into the professional ring.
Kimweri looks a lot better this round. Bajawa's had his moments, but it's a Kimweri round.
That's round 2.
It's certainly a Kimweri round, inclusive of that knockdown in the early segments.
Double jab is working really good now, isn't it? See? Right. Deep breath. What about we try, double it up, right to the body, and come up with the left hook all at once. Give it a go. I reckon you'll get in with it. Keep your head moving. You're going well, mate. Nice relax. Deep breath. Come on. Another deep breath. Come on. Give me a big, big deep breath. Good.
We look into round number 2, and there's the head clash as Kimweri goes down, launches into the forehead. Oh, Bajawa. Very lucky that there was no cut from that.
Take it down, please.
Round 3 coming your way on Fox Sports Friday Night Fights.
All the heads come together again. Good skills on both fighters, and good solid punches for the weight of the boys as they trade in the red corner.
Edging forward here, the Indonesian, and for a good part of round number 3, and in fact a lot of round number 1 dominated that ring position. Round number 2 was all the new Australians.
You can see in the first fight I pointed out about Mark Delby moving around the ring a little bit too far. This is what I meant. You can move around the outside and box on the outside, but you don't need to be so far away. And Kimwari's only just outside distance all the time, which means he can let his shots go and catch out Bajawa at any time. Small movements, try and catch your opponent out. Big amateur background, and we went to the Melbourne Commonwealth Games, Omari Kimweri.
Going to have a chat later to Australian Cruiserweight Champion Brad Pitt, here live from Melbourne, and his team. Edging forward, sticking out that left hand at the moment, Bajawa, but really not following it with anything of substance. Rattled in the second round. Not too badly, but confidence is down.
Yeah, you can see the difference in Kimweri from the first round. I thought Bajawa got the first, then Kimweri put him down in the second, and he just seems to have his confidence flowing at the moment, Kimweri.
While we're focusing on the lighter divisions, of course, our congratulations must go to Billy Dibb, the new IBF featherweight champion of the world after defeating Jorge Lasiemba in Sydney last Friday night. Congratulations to Billy and his family and his team on realising a dream. 30 seconds remaining, round number three.
It's been a close round. Oh, as Bajawa lands a good shot, good left hook.
Was a good left hand from the Indonesian. Looking for his 10th victory here tonight. Only the two knockouts in his 9 wins thus far. So they're not heavy hands. They'll accumulate though.
That's round three.
And back to the corners we go for the final time. Just a 4-rounder here. And we are next on your screen, August 26th. On Fox Sports 2, once again, an 8 p.m. bell time. Robert Whaley and Anthony Brownlee, our headline act. Michael O'Donnell and Danny Price. Adrian Campbell, Jason Kanofsky on the undercard as well. We are live from Cronulla, August 26th. Aussie versus Aussie doing their thing on Friday Night Fights.
Doesn't want to punch when you impact punch. Impact round. Sadly, players like Kane, Hopkins, Manan.
Urgency in the corner because this is the fourth and final round, and once again it looks like we're going to get the calculators out and ask Ignatius Missalides, Andrew Campbell and Anika Williams to add them up as we are headed for the judges, it appears, at this stage.
Nice jab from Kimweri. He's got great movements, great skill level, Kimweri. Good footwork.
Yep. Just difficulty in finding opponents at these lighter weights.
Oh, nice combination on the counter there from Bajawa.
Both young men put together a good right hand. In fact, a couple there from Bajawa.
The old smile.
Bajawa has not changed emotion facially anyway since the moment he was called out of the dressing room.
Bajawa tries to trot forward and cut Kimweri off, who switches into the southpaw stance. He's got to work around the outside of that front foot if he's going to do that, Kimweri, or walk into a right hand. Oh, good lead hook.
Halfway through the fourth and final round. Ranked at number 3 in the Commonwealth of light flyweight is Omari Kimweri.
A couple of young Australian fighters just made history. Two young junior fighters, one from Queensland, Clay Waterman, and Joy Opataya from New South Wales, won the gold medal at the World Championships. First ever gold medal at any World Championships for amateur boxing for Australia. Positive times. Damien Hooper won a gold at the Youth Olympics last year. Brett Mather won a bronze medal at the Worlds. Both silver at the Youth Olympic Games for Mather. So positive times in the amateurs coming through for Australian boxing as well as in the professional ranks.
Good exchange there with 40 seconds remaining in the round. Both good amateurs, these young men. In fact, Kimweri came out here to Melbourne representing Tanzania at the Commonwealth Games in 2006 and decided he liked it so much that he'd stay.
As did a lot of the fighters.
And that was the case after the 2000 Sydney Olympics.
Australia certainly benefited with some of them, with Solomon Eggemine and Fariz Karayuki.
For Ben Robardis to name a few. Bell sounds, that is it. Omari Kimweri, Junior Bajawa. Crowd, a massive one here in Melbourne. Sitting back, most of them enjoying their dinner here tonight. Three course feed. Great venue. Maybe that was the appetizer at Super Flyweight from Bajawa and Kimweri. As we count down to the business end of the night, up next, Jay Bryce, Kane Watts, Joseph Quajo, Blake Caparello, and Ahmet Diaz, and Lenny Zappavigna, who has got plenty of support in the form of the mighty Penrith Panthers, who are here in the Southern Capital to face the Melbourne Storm tomorrow night to kick off Fox Sports Super Saturday. And the entire team is here to support Lenny.
I've seen Lenny doing some training on Fox Sports out with the Penrith Panthers.
And believe me, they are in absolute awe of the young bloke.
It's good to see the sports combined.
Yep.
Some of the better moments from the fourth and final round. Equal right hands there from Kimweri and Bajawa. Oh, the lead uppercut. Well, they stood, they let him go.
Yep.
Nice right hand from Bajawa. He had his moments throughout the fight. I think we'll see Kimweri come up victor, but
yep,
Bajawa wasn't disgraced.
I'm just waiting on the scorecards to come in. And they are in, so we will go centre ring and make it official, and we will do so to Mr. Howard Lee.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Both fighters come to centre ring. We have a unanimous decision. Judge Ignatius Mitsilatis has it 39-36. Andrew Campbell has it 40-35. Final card, Anika Williams, 39-36. Unanimous points winner, blue corner, Omari the Lion Man, Kimweri.
Omari Kimweri, victorious unanimous points decision victor, and he did it easily. Two fights down, three remains.